Before being purchased by the CN Railroad in the spring of 2004, the Duluth, Missabe, and Iron Range was an ore-hauling railroad located in northeastern Minnesota's Iron Range. Also known as the Missabe, the DM&IR's main line runs from the Lake Superior ore docks in Duluth up through the Iron Range and continues to additional docks in Two Harbors. Along with taconite pellets, the DM&IR also ships limestone, bentonite clay, and grinding materials to the taconite pellet producing plants. Other commodities are shipped to various customers on the line, including coal, ballast, and wood products. C-Vision Productions captures the Duluth, Missabe, and Iron Range in its final year before the CN purchase. We follow movement on both the Missabe Division from Duluth to the Minntac facility at Mountain Iron. We also get a glimpse of the Iron Range Division from Iron Junction to Two Harbors. A more unique mix of trains are found on the Missabe Division, and that's where we will concentrate most of our time in this show. Along with taconite movements, limestone trains are seen frequently, as well as some short freight trains. Adding to the traffic are all rail trains interchanged from Class 1 railroads that run on the DM&IR to and from the iron ore processing plants. These all rail trains are basically ore trains that run from the processing plants to the steel mills completely by rail, compared to the Missabe's ore trains that run only to the docks where the pellets are transloaded to lake vessels. The all rail trains are operated on the Missabe by DM&IR crews, but retain their original power from the Class 1 railroads that take the trains to the steel mills. We will follow this line from the docks in Duluth to Mountain Iron, along with movement on the Virginia branch that includes raw ore trains that run from the Thunderbird North Mine in Eveleth to the United Taconite Plant in Forbes. Starting in Duluth, we set up next to the Missabe's ore docks. Dock number 6, which is the largest ore dock on the Great Lakes, sits next to dock number 5, which is inactive. This dock was taken out of service in 1985. Dock 6 was completed in 1918. The Proctor road switch is on duty at the dock and is setting out a train load of ore that is going to be stockpiled on the other side of the dock. It is about to put together a set of empties to be taken back up to Proctor, which is just a few miles from the dock and adjacent to Duluth. This scene was captured in February 2004, and the lake ports were closed for the winter. Ore moves year-round, and when the lakes are frozen, the Missabe stockpiles the pellets to be moved later during the shipping season. The 7-mile line from Duluth to Proctor is known as Proctor Hill. With a 2.2% grade, it is a popular spot to watch trains on the Missabe. At Collingwood Junction, which is just west of the Duluth docks, the Proctor road switch is on its way back to Proctor. On another day, the Proctor road switch is heading downgrade at the same crossing with a set of mini quads that will be loaded with limestone for the Minorca plant. Just up the line a few hundred yards, a set of light power from a Proctor road switch that just got done working on the dock is heading back to Proctor. The most famous spot for train photography on the Missabe is here at Spirit Mountain Curve. A lot has changed here over the years, including the discontinuation of the use of the second main track. Coming up the hill, an SD38AC is in charge of a loaded limestone train for the Minorca mine just north of Virginia, Minnesota. Before moving on, we get a chance to view the yard and facilities in Proctor. CN had no plans at the time before the purchase of using any of the facilities in Proctor, leaving this historic area uncertain of its fate. Proctor Yard also includes a full-service locomotive maintenance facility and a car shop. On the north end of the yard is the scale. Minntac trains weigh here before their train is taken to the Duluth dock. Here, a Minntac extra train arrives at the scale. It proceeds slowly to allow the scale to accurately weigh each car. Just a couple miles up the line is the town of Adolph and SL Junction. It is here that the interstate branch to South Itasca, Wisconsin joins the main line. The all-rail trains interchange from the BNSF, UP, and CN come up this branch to access the pellet plants. Coming from the north is the loaded Minntac Extra we viewed previously at the scales. Engine 223 is in charge of this train today. It is one of Missabe's SD38DC locomotives. Munger is the spot where the CN's ex-Duluth, Winnipeg, and Pacific main line crosses over the DM&IR. That Minntac Extra is seen once again with its load of steaming pellets. On the other side of the overpass, the Munger Tavern stands next to the main line. This bar has been here since the steam days. Only one could imagine what this building has seen over the years if it had eyes. One of those all-rail trains is heading through town and under the CN overpass. This is BNSF's train that runs to the USX Fairfield Mill in Birmingham, Alabama. It is heading to the Minntac mine for loading. The old depot in Saginaw still stands and was recently still used for the Saginaw section. However, the railroad eliminated that section and the depot is now unused and has been scheduled for demolition. At the time of the CN takeover, it still remained standing. Approaching the depot is a loaded limestone train for Minntac, led with one of Missabe's rebuilt tunnel motors. These tunnel motors are old SD45 T-2s and are now classified by the railroad as SD40-3s. Two of the 400 series units, number 416 and 418, were rebuilt using SD45-2 bodies. An empty Minorca train encounters the Cloquet River Bridge at Burnett. With the temperature at 10 below zero Fahrenheit, an SD38-2 leads another set of Minntac limestone loads at Burnett. Minntac empties approach the community of Culver. At the same location, a train from United Taconite negotiates the S-curve south of Culver. Engine 414 leads Minorca empties through Alborn. The Minntac limestone loads roll through Payne. Another BNSF all-rail train is next through Payne. This train handles pellets to the USX Edgar Thompson plant near Pittsburgh. Led by two BNSF SD-75s, these trains also use CSX power since they are transferred to the CSX in Chicago. In the tiny town of Kelsey, the tracks span the Whiteface River. Starting with the limestone loads, we see both a winter and summer scene from this photogenic spot. DM&IR's first SDM rebuild number 301 helps in the consist of this empty United taconite train through Sachs. Number 301 was XSD18 number 174. At milepost 51, northbound trains enter CTC territory to Minntac. Fairlane is the point where the main line diverges to the processing plant at Forbes. At the time this scene was captured in July of 2003, the EVTEC plant was closed due to the lack of pellet contracts. The future of this plant seemed bleak because of the declining steel industry in the U.S. But not all hope was lost, as there were rumors of reopening the plant later that year. Approaching Fairlane is a Minntac limestone train. With the demand of steel ever so needed in China, a new deal was struck with Cleveland-Cliffs and Chinese-based Laoyi Steel in November of 2003 to reopen the Forbes plant. 1 month later, the plant was brought back to life and Missabe trains were once again seen serving the newly formed United Taconite facility. A set of loaded pellets is alongside an empty raw ore train and is ready to depart. Heading back to Fairlane, we see the loaded train curving on the main line on a frigid 15 below zero January morning. After the United Taconite loads clear, engine 418, which is one of two XSD-45-2s, leads a train to Minntac. Coming into United Taconite at Fairline is the set of empties that include engine 301 in the consist. In Forbes, the town's depot still stands guard by the tracks and is the backdrop for a limestone train. Iron Junction is the busiest spot on the whole system. It is here where the Iron Range Division to Two Harbors diverges from the Missabe Division. Approaching Iron Junction is a set of Minntac empties from Proctor. Up the line a couple miles is Wolf, which is the junction of the Virginia branch. This line runs to the Thunderbird North mine that produces the raw ore for the United Taconite plant. It is also the line that runs to the Minorca plant that is north of Virginia. Coming off the Virginia branch is the Keenan Switch, which is taking a set of empty mini quads that were loaded with limestone and some loads of ballast to the Keenan yard. A little later, we will come back to the Virginia branch to view the Thunderbird movements that run from the mine to United Taconite, simply known as T-Bird trains. Just north of Wolf, at County Road 316, we see the Keenan Switch heading to Minntac with a train load of bentonite clay, followed by the limestone train. The north end of the Missabe Division is at Mountain Iron. Just north of town is the mine and processing plant called Minntac. It is the Missabe's largest customer that opened in 1967 and is North America's largest taconite plant. Most pellets from Minntac go to Two Harbors, although it isn't uncommon for Minntac pellets to go to Duluth. Many of the all-rail movements for BNSF are loaded here. The first train is a set of Missabe loads that are destined for Two Harbors. Thank you. After the Missabe loads clear, a BNSF Fairfield train leaves Minntac heading for its home rails at Saunders Junction south of Superior, Wisconsin. We are now going to head back to the Virginia branch to view the T-bird trains that haul raw ore to the United Taconite plant. The reason we are focusing on these trains is because they utilize the few remaining rebuilt SD-9 and SD-18s left on the Missabe's roster. These units were rebuilt by the Missabe and are now classified as SDMs. Engine 317, which was ex-SD-9 number 167, is about ready to depart T-bird north. Just ahead of the train, the DM&IR tracks cross the CN mainline on a diamond at a point called Largo on the DM&IR and Shelton Junction on the CN. The T-Bird is waiting for the southbound CN freight before heading to United Taconite. Later in the day, another run is getting ready to depart T-Bird North. This train is led with DM&IR's SD38-2, number 212. Two loads in an empty T-bird are seen at Iron Junction. The first train is led with SDM number 316, which is XSD18 number 186. Just north of Fairlane, engine 212 takes this empty T-bird back to the mine. Our last two T-birds we will see are entering the plant at Fairlane. To finish our show, we will get a glimpse of the Missabe's Iron Range Division, which runs from Iron Junction to Two Harbors. This section of the Missabe is one of the most scenic, but less accessible lines as it runs through the Northwoods of Minnesota. It also doesn't see the variety of trains the Missabe Division does, as the majority of movements are Minntac and Minorca interdivisional trains, also known as IDs. These trains commonly are operated with two rebuilt tunnel motors. Starting at Iron Junction, a loaded Minntac ID passes the CSX led Edgar Thompson train we saw earlier at South Kelsey. The bone-chilling 15 degree below zero temperature enhances the steamy pellets as it rounds the curve onto the Iron Range Division. Just a couple miles from Iron Junction, the Missabe crosses the CN main once again at a point called Ramshaw. A loaded Minorca ID is led with engine number 400 and prepares to cross the diamond. The town of Bewabik still retains some of its railroad heritage. The old Duluth and Iron Range roundhouse and water tower still stands, along with the old depot. Bewabik was at one time a crew change point between the Iron Range and Missabe divisions and had a large classification yard before being downsized in the 1980s. South of the city of Hoyt Lakes is Allen Junction. This junction once led the tracks to Ely before that line was abandoned in the early 1980s. At Fairbanks, the Minorca ID highballs the siding and passes over one of the many defect detectors along the system. Heavy loads of pellets keep track maintenance and maintainers very busy, especially in the cold winter months. Eighteen miles north of Two Harbors is Wales. A section house sits alongside the tracks as a crew is based here. It is also the point where the 12-mile Jordan Branch splits to a junction with North Shore Mining Railroad at North Shore Junction. This branch is used by the miscellaneous road freight, which operates from Two Harbors to Proctor twice a week. Coming from the north is a Minntac ID led with the traditional two tunnel motors. The train is just about to apex one of the many grades on this subdivision before swinging straight south to Two Harbors. Just south of Wales is the north switch of Highland Siding. Here an empty Minntac ID meets a set of loads. The loads are slowing in preparation of weighing each car at the automatic weigh-in-motion Highland scale, which is located midway on the scale track. Catching up to the loads, we watch as they obey the 2 mile per hour speed limit over the scale. The information from here is relayed to the docks in Two Harbors. On another day, the miscellaneous road freight is seen as it heads past Highland Lake and bypasses the scale on its way to Two Harbors. After weighing the cars at the scale in Highland, two loaded trains continued southward to Two Harbors. We have reached the end of the Iron Range Division and our look at the Duluth, Missabe, and Iron Range at Two Harbors. Coming downhill and about to cross over Highway 61, a Minntac ID heads into the yard and dock facilities. The Missabe was a great regional railroad that was always known as the most popular to many rail fans in the Great Lakes region. It is one that will be missed by many for years to come, as it is now in the ownership of the CN. It will be hard to forget the beauty of the maroon and gold locomotives and the sounds of those great P5 horns echoing in the North Woods of Minnesota. We hope you enjoyed our look at the DM&IR, and watch for more great railroad programs from C Vision Productions.